抓紧时间来看一下课文。首先，在读课文之前呢，还是给大家出了一个问题啊：How long did the exam last? How long did the exam last? 也就是说问，问考试持续了多长时间？OK, now listen carefully. How was the exam, Richard?
Not too bad. I think I passed in English and mathematics. The questions were very easy. How about you, Gary?
The English and math paper weren't easy enough for me. I hope I haven't failed.
I think I failed the French paper. I could answer 16 of the questions. They were very easy, but I couldn't answer the rest.
They were too difficult for me.
French tests are awful, aren't they? I hate them.
I'm sure I've got a low mark.
Oh, cheer up. Perhaps we didn't do too badly.
The guy next to me wrote his name at the top of the paper.
Yes?
Then he sat there and looked at it for 3 hours. He didn't write a word.
Listen once more.
How was the exam, Richard?
Not too bad. I think I passed in English and mathematics. The questions were very easy. How about you, Gary?
The English and math papers weren't easy enough for me. I hope I haven't failed.
I think I failed the French paper. I could answer 16 of the questions. They were very easy. But I couldn't answer the rest.
They were too difficult for me.
French tests are awful, aren't they?
I hate them.
I'm sure I've got a low mark.
Oh, cheer up! Perhaps we didn't do too badly.
The guy next to me wrote his name at the top of the paper.
Yes?
Then he sat there and looked at it for 3 hours. He didn't write a word.
OK, 那么我们首先来看一下课文。Gary 问 Richard, How was the exam, Richard? 考试考得怎么样？那么大家对这样一个句型应该是非常熟悉，也就是 how 加上系动词，那么后面加上 something 或者是 somebody, 表示的是什么东西或者是什么人怎么样。那么问人的时候呢，一般都是用来问人的身体或者是生活情况。比如说生活如何 ?How is life? How is life? 那么情况怎么样 ?How are things? How are things? OK, 那么我们继续往下看。
Not too bad. I think I passed in English and mathematics. The questions were very easy. How about you, Gary?
不算太坏，我想我的英语和数学及格了，题目很容易。那么你呢？在这里 ,not too bad 指的是不算太坏。那么 too 它表示的是过于，它具有否定含义。如果说太重了，我搬不动。
It's too heavy, I can't lift it. It's too heavy, I can't lift it.
房间太小了。
The room is too small. The room is too small.
那么 too 经常用在这样的一个句型当中。too for somebody to do something 表示对某人来说什么东西太怎么样了，以至于不能怎么样。如果说考试太难，以至于他不能通过。
The exam is too difficult for her to pass. The exam is too difficult for her to pass.
考试太难了，以至于他不能通过。Too difficult 表示太难了。For her 表示对他。那么后面 to pass 表示不能通过。OK, 那么接下来这个小男孩，这个男孩子太小了，还不能参军。
The boy is too young to join the army. The boy is too young to join the army.
指的是这个男孩子太小了，还不能参军。那么 too young, 太小了 ,to join the army.以至于不能参军。我们继续再来看这样一个例子，如果说这件事对这个孩子来说太难做了。
It's too difficult for the child to do it. It's too difficult for the child to do it.
OK, 那么 too difficult, 太难了。For the child, 表示对这个孩子，那么 to do it, 以至于不能做。OK, 那么 too, 我们还可以借 that 从句，那么记住这样的一个句型 too,怎么样，然后再加 that 从句。那么一般情况下呢 ,that 从句都是否定形式。比如说 我们把上面的例子再重新做一下。The boy is too young that he can't join the army. The boy is too young that he can't join the army. 那么指的是这个孩子太小了，还不能参军。那么和上面的这句 The boy is too young to join the army 意思是一样的。OK, 那我们再接下来看这样的一句话。It's too difficult that the child can't do it. It's too difficult that the child can't do it. 那么它指的是这件事太难了，这个孩子做不了，和我们上句所说的 It's too difficult for the child to do it 说的是一样的事情。 OK, 那么 I think 它后面接的是宾语从句，那么大家都知道了，我们讲过 pass 它可以表示通过考试，那么如果是具体的学科或者是科目，我们应该在 pass 的后面加上一个介词 in。 那么接下来 how about 指的是什么怎么样，用来征求别人的意见或者是询问情况，相当于 what about。 那么接下来 Gary 又说 The English and math papers weren't easy enough for me. I hope I haven't failed. 英语和数学的试题对我来说不容易，我希望别不及格。 The English and math papers 指的是英文和数学的试卷，那么 paper 做试卷讲的时候呢，它是一个可数名词。What's easy enough for me 指的是对我不够简单。 Enough 它的用法一般都是放在形容词之后，那么比如说这个房间对我们来说够大了， The room is big enough for us. The room is big enough for us. 那我们知道 big 它是形容词，那么 enough 一般都是放在形容词的后面。我们再来看这样一个例子，如果说这本书对我来说不算有趣， The book isn't interesting enoughFor me, the book isn't interesting enough for me. 那么同样 interesting 它是形容词，我们把 enough 放在它的后面。 Enough 一般都是放在名词之前，比如说他没有买计算机因为他没有钱了。 He didn't buy the computer because he didn't have enough money. 那么 money 指的是钱，那么它是名词，我们把 enough 放在名词之前。那么这样的一个句型 enough for somebody 或者是 something to do something 指的是对某人或者是某物来说足够做某事的了。这个房间不够大，不够住三个人的。 The room isn't big enough for three people to live in. The room isn't big enough for three people to live in. 再比如你儿子够大了，可以自立了。 Your son is old enoughto live by himself. Your son is old enough to live by himself. 那么 I hope I haven't failed. I hope 它后面接的是宾语从句。那么 I hope that I haven't failed 表示我希望别不及格，那么 that 被省略掉了。 OK, 那么我们接着往下看 Richard 是怎么样回答的。 I think I failed the French paperI could answer 16 of the questions. They were very easy, but I couldn't answer the rest. They were too difficult for me. 我想我的法语及不了格了，我只能回答其中的16个问题。那么这些题呢很容易，但我回答不出其余的问题，那些题对我来说太难了。 Failed 它是 fail 的过去式， Failed French paper 指的是法语不及格，那么 could 它是 can 的过去式，表示能够。这个考试是发生在过去，因此我们应该用一般过去式 could。 Answer 16 of the questions 指的是回答16个问题，那么 the rest 指的是其余的其他的考题。 Too difficult for me 表示对我来说太难了。 OK, 那么 Gary 接着问 French tests are awful, aren't they? 法语考试太可怕了，你说呢？那么这是一个反义疑问句啊，大家都已经知道了。接下来 Richard 说 I hate them, I'm sure I've got a low mark. 我讨厌法语，我的法语成绩肯定很低。那么 hate 在这里面表示的是讨厌， I'm sure 后面接的是宾语从句， I've got 表示 I have got, 那么它就相当于 I have. A low mark 表示低分。那么接下来 Gary 又说Oh, cheer up, perhaps we didn't do too badly.
The guy next to me wrote his name at the top of the paper.
OK, 那么 Gary 又来安慰 Richard 说啊，别灰心，或许我们考的还不至于那么太糟。那么坐在我旁边的那个人呢，只在试卷上写了自己的名字。Cheer up 表示高兴一点，别灰心，那么振作起来。Perhaps 表示可能，也许，它相当于 maybe。Do something badly 指的是做得很糟糕。那么 next to 表示在谁的旁边， next to me 指的是在我的旁边。那么在这里呢，是做定语来修饰 the guy。Wrote his name at the top of the paper 指的是在试卷顶端写了自己的名字。At the top of 指的是在什么什么的顶端，那么它的反义词是 at the bottom of， at the bottom of 在什么什么的末端。 OK， 那么我们再继续往下看。 Richard 问，是吗？
Yes。 Then he sat there and looked it for 3 hours. He didn't write a word.
然后他就坐在那里对着考卷看了3个小时，一个字儿也没写。那么讲到这里呢，相信大家已经发现了答案。那我们的问题是 How long did the exam last? How long did the exam last? 考试持续了多久？那么那个人坐在那里瞅着试卷长达3个小时，很显然，那么这次考试是进行了3个小时。 The answer should be It lasted for 3 hours. It lasted for 3 hours. 那么在这里大家要注意一下，那么谓语动词应该用一般过去时 lasted。 OK， 那么 then 表示的是然后，表示接下来的动作。 Looked it for 3 hours 表示对着试卷看了3个小时。那么 it 在这里指的是 the paper 试卷。 A word 是一个字。 Didn't write a word 表示一个字都没有写。